always wanted to do something in music. There was no other option of doing anything else. I learned the tabla myself for about 4 years when I was in college, and I actually wanted to become a professional tabla player to perform with singers and be sort of a percussionist. But once I got into college, I saw these DJs coming into college and, you know, attracting a lot of female fan following and everything. So I thought, let me give it a shot. I had a pretty good collection of music. One thing led to another, and by the time I was done with my BCom, we were like fully into it. So DJing was just, it just happened. Well, according to me, the top three things that a person should have to become a DJ is rhythm, rhythm, and rhythm. That's it. If you don't have that, then you can't become a DJ. In fact, in our institute itself, when a student comes to enroll, the first thing that we do is we start a song, actually not a song, a few songs, with different tempos, and we make them actually either dance, tap their foot, or clap to the beat. If they can't do that properly, then I know that the person doesn't have the rhythm in him. Three things most important to become a DJ is rhythm, rhythm, and rhythm. Well, I think one of the biggest mistakes that most of the upcoming DJs are making is using technology so much that they are losing the essence of the music and the creativity. All the new CD players which have come right now have this thing called the sync button. You don't have to even match the beats, you don't have to do anything. The new DJs just come, press the button and start mixing, and that's it. And they lose out on knowing the fact that the machine can make a mistake. Because I've spent so much time in the music industry, it's been about 22 years since I started DJing, I had come across a lot of different types of entertainment in my life, and there was a friend of mine, Krish, who has been telling me to get into doing entertainment for events. And there was a very close family friend's function, and we just decided that let's give it a shot over here, it'd be a nice thing to do. And that function went off so well, the artists which we selected, the whole curation was done so perfectly, and then people started asking our friend whose party it was, but who did this entertainment lineup for you? And he gave our names, and then we thought maybe this is something that we should get into, and it'll be really nice to do. The most important thing about your night out is that one of the persons who's in your night out is already into entertainment and into the music industry and the entertainment industry, which is me. And there are a lot of other event companies which are there in the market, but they all are people who have just come from either event degrees or colleges and who've gotten into events, but they haven't actually seen the artist side of entertainment, which I have seen. So I think that makes a very, very big difference when I'm actually selecting the artist for functions and events. So that is one thing. Another thing is my partner Krish, who's there, has already been doing decor for events and weddings since the last 15 years. So when you have two people who have the background in the entertainment industry and the event industry since the last 15 to 20 years, it makes a big difference when you start something new. I think the advice I like to give to the youth is that I followed my passion, I gave it a shot, and it worked out really well for me. So if you have something within you, something that you want to do, then don't just look away from it or keep it as a hobby. Give it a shot. In today's day and age, alternative careers are very, very important, very big, and they're doing really well. So give your passion a shot, you may just make it in it.